calcination process for the conversion of ore into metal oxides involves heating of those ores just below their fusion point or fusion temperature. During this process, volatile impurities will be eliminated out, whereas the oxides are left behind. Let us have some examples for this. When Fe2O3.xH2O, which present in solid form, when heated during the calcination process, it is converted into Fe2O3+xH2O. So it is the formed water molecules are eliminated during this process. Next one, when zinc carbonate participates in calcination, it produces zinc oxide with the liberation of carbon dioxide gas. Similarly, when calcium carbonate dot magnesium carbonate, a mixture of carbonates heated double salts, it produces calcium oxide plus magnesium oxide plus formation of carbon dioxide. So just identify other forms of ores are converted into their oxide forms by heating these ores up to just below their fusion temperature. So during this process, if there is any volatile substances present as impurities, that will be eliminated out as in the gaseous form. So this process is called as calcination process. And second process used by us is roasting. One more method available for us is roasting. What is roasting is, it is a process in which the ores are heated in the presence of oxygen. Okay, in this process, the sulfide ores, especially the sulfide ores, are heated in the presence of oxygen up to just below the temperature of that freezing or sorry below the temperature of their boiling point or melting point. So during, while we are going to heat those ores, sulfide ores, in the presence of oxygen just below their boiling or melting points, what will be expected? One, the sulfide ores are going to react with oxygen and produces zinc oxide plus the formation of sulfur dioxide. Similarly, so this is where one more, iron sulfide also, when reacted with oxygen or participates in roasting, it converted into ferrous oxide and again formation of sulfur dioxide. Similarly, cupric sulfide, that is sulfide ore of copper, undergoes roasting process and produces cuprous oxide with the liberation of sulfur dioxide. Remember, in each step there is the liberation of sulfur dioxide. The released sulfur dioxide gas is used in the preparation of concentrated or sulfuric acid. Okay, it is used in the preparation of sulfuric acid, whereas all the sulfide ores are converted into their oxide ores. Remember, this process is called as roasting process. The roasting process will take place in a furnace. It is takes place in a furnace. The roasting process of metals takes place in a furnace, especially in case of copper sulfide, Cu2S, copper sulfide. The roasting process of copper sulfide takes place in reverberatory furnace takes place in reverberatory furnace. Here the reverberator furnace, when cuprous sulfide is reacted with oxygen, can produce cuprous oxide. So this formed cuprous oxide will have impurity iron oxide as impurity. Okay, FeO as impurity present with this process. To eliminate these iron oxide, to this iron oxide we are going to add silica. So upon addition of silica, the iron oxide impurities may react with silica to produce iron silicates. So this iron silicate will left as slag. So this the best way is, when compared to gong, the slag will be easily removable during the metallurgic processes. So this is roasting process. So after completion of conversion, or during the extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore, the two important processes are, first one is conversion of ore into oxide. So this will be possible in two methods. One is calcination method, heating of ore in absence of oxygen or less supply of oxygen just below the fusion temperature. So to convert our ores into their oxide form, during this process all volatile impurities will be eliminated out. Second method for this conversion of oxides or conversion of ores into oxides are by roasting process. In this roasting process, the sulfide, especially sulfide ores, are heated up to the melting points in the presence of or inside of the furnace. So it takes place and converts into oxide ores or oxide forms of metals. Next, and the second method, reduction of oxide to get metal. Reduction of oxide to get crude metal. The second step involved in extraction of crude metal from concentrated ore is reduction of oxide to get crude metal. First step, all other forms of ores are converted into oxide form. In second step, reduction of those oxide forms are metal oxides to get crude metals. During this process, all metal oxides are heated with carbon. So let us have some example. M2O3, or we can generalize the example is MXOY, when reacted with carbon, excess amount of carbon can produce XM with the generation of carbon monoxide, CO, carbon oxidized to carbon monoxide. Let us have one example. When M2O3 types of metal oxides heated with carbon produces 2 moles of metal and 3 moles of carbon monoxide. So this is reduction of oxide to get crude metal. During all our explanations, one important question may be expected in the examination, that is the differences between gong and slag. Remember, the gong is difficult to process. That means it requires some additional processes to eliminate gong from ores, whereas slag can easily removable from the